out of all today's the days.
Today's the day.
That's actually true. I didn't even think about that part. Yeah.
Like, probably years.
It doesn't feel as
Okay, so I think we have the mic actually plugged in this time. So on the last video, the little cable from the Rode mic into the camera wasn't plugged in all the way. And I didn't realize it until I was editing the footage and kind of realized, hey, this audio sounds like crap. So I apologize for that. To the topic of the day. We are moving into day three of filming. It is Saturday. We are going to the bar right now, which is awesome. It's exciting. Complete strangers, you know, pulling through, being there for us. That's awesome. We have Zach, Paul, Cooper, and Layla today, and started off about 6:30 or so going to Walmart to get blackout curtains, because I think the front of this bar actually has a lot of windows. This is supposed to be a nighttime scene. The original bar was just black. It was dingy. It was a dive bar. This seems to be a little bit of an upgrade, but I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. That goes again to speaking about bending your script and kind of using what you can. And that's the most important thing. You know, we're still going to be telling the story. We're still going to be shooting the script. The dialogue is still the same. I'm about to go start rounding up talent and then meeting everybody else who's just going to be there at the bar. Very thankful. My wife is going to be there today to help me kind of manage the set and keep track of everything, which that's a fucking lifesaver, to be honest with you. Let's go ahead and get to the bar and start blacking this thing out.
I mean, I like people. Like, I like you guys. But it's just like, things get weird as you get older.
Yeah, we
did.
The rest on the right side, and then it goes around on the left. Okay. Does that work?
Boom.
I know you don't really wear this.
I
cute.
Thought you would like that.
Well,
it's been a long time, haven't it?
Can use that.
Finally made it back.
Where does Rust come from?
He just materializes.
We really don't know where Rust comes from.
So I don't have him. He just enters the scene, basically.
Okay.
Because
okay.
I don't have him walking in the front door. I don't want to give. It's like Zach. Like, yeah. Rust and Zach kind of just, like, appear and disappear
okay.
at random times.
So, whatever you want. Make it just like a name. Short, to the point.
Which one?
Huh? Jill? Great.
Because some people are going to ask, I'm recording, well, I'm using a C100. It's not 4K. Obviously. The AC just kicked on, and again, I'm not gonna turn it off. We're in Texas. Get real. C100. Why am I using a C100? Well, for work, I usually use a lot of 4K cameras, but really, I don't give a shit about 4K. What I care about primarily is the C100 is a workhorse. I can get a great image out of it. I'm using the NTG4 Plus. Which is just awesome. It's clear, it's crispy. The lens that I have on here right now, it's not my only lens, obviously, but it is a Rokinon 35mm, Rokinon, however you want to say. And then I'm recording everything out to the Atmos Ninja. What is it, the Ninja Blade? Yeah, the Atmos Ninja Blade RAW. And log. This is all stuff that I own. And that's the other reason for filming on a C100 is the way that I'm shooting and how ambitious this project is, it's not a short film that I can film in a weekend or even a week. This is, again, about 200 pages of content and a ton of different locations. I thought about going down the route of renting gear, because I do that. for commercial shoots. But yeah, I mean, I'm able to film any day that I want, any time that I want. I can do pickup shots, I can do reshoots, I can do anything like that, and I own the gear. So that's what I'm using to film. So criticize all you want. I also use, I've got a bunch of Zacuto rig stuff. I love their stuff. You know, that's the rails that I'm using. And yeah, I mean, it all works just pretty damn well. Now, truth be told, the other scenes, I didn't just use this lens. I think I used a Sigma on day one and this, and then on day two. Oh, on day one, I also used the 10-18 Canon, which is a wide angle or super wide, whatever, for the car shots. Today, I just used the 35. I actually didn't switch. So that's what I'm using for that. I do have external audio recorders. I mean, I have several reasons or excuses to use this camera, but I love it. I could definitely see moving up to the C200 now that that's out, and I've seen some of the footage and the specs on that. That looks pretty freaking cool.
Well, that's why I'm just... Because I'm not going to say, like, what's up, boss. So would you say, get him my usual Jill and then just cut blank? I was just feeling it out for what he wants. Now that this role's female, not male.
Oh my okay. God.
Hold right, on.
$8. God damn.
It's Robert. It is Robert.
I'm just going to smoke a cigarette in the sand. And I'll leave him here for
Zach wanted
once.
An excuse to use the vending machine because he's never bought...
Huh? Oh, are we?
Yeah, we're not smoking. If it's like short and quick, it'd probably be alright.
Yeah, I think it'd be cool. Like one just like cut over.
Yeah, it's not like a whole cigarette.
Like, cause what I could do is...
Such a brave
how would I do that? I think that'd be cool though. You know what I mean? Cause I mean, what am I gonna do? I mean, I'm creeping, right? Well, if I'm smoking...
He's never bought cigarettes out of a machine and he wanted to do it.
Yeah, I'll leave these here for somebody that actually smokes. Let's see here.
Wait, get the one with the lighter.
Special blends, gross. Where's 27? Let's see here.
What do you want? So like right from where you are, to him talking to you, to exit. And then...
Oh, we're just going to need to do a dialogue, aren't we? Okay.
And then bring in dark beer.
Yep, and then bring in dark beer. And then we're going to cut, and then we're going to do Mitch walking around.
All right.
Did you just want to ask me and get it over with? You're like, well, I guess you can trash this piss water. And then, honestly, I could probably just cut to a low angle right here. If you want to just take it and put it to the side for a second.
And later we'll
And then later I can cut a shot of you, like, I'm obviously not used to being behind a bar. I'm clumsy.
So...
I'll take a little sip of this.
What's up?
Don't
get
drunk.
Oh,
good.
I think it's
Arnold Palmer.
Arnie P.
Yeah.
I can't have any carbs. God.
You have a line that says, "Don't go tearing down my bar." Did you?
When they after they ignore the bartender, or you want me just go about my day?
I think she goes over the top of her.
Yeah. You're sassy.
It's not.
You're a sassy woman. You're in a position over shoulder to
okay.
her. So we're gonna pull her into focus and pull her into the scene that way at this point in time. And then we're gonna cut again as she gets up and walks over. And because there's like kind of like a little bit of awkward space there
mm-hmm.
where it's like the two look at each other
yeah.
and like acknowledge each other. It's like, it really does look like shitty piss beer.
But this looks more like Shiner Bock than
this. Yeah, but it still yeah. at least has the fuzzy.
Shiner's good though. Good Texas boy, he's gonna like some Shiner.
That's the Nickelback angle right there.
I like pants round feet. That's what song's gonna be playing when you walk in, okay?
Alright, let's go.
Oh, sorry. Cooper's Canadian. His favorite band's probably Nickelback.
Oh, come on.
Nice.
I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with
it's
you.
It's the national anthem, right?
I like pants round the feet. Sorry, man. Couldn't help it.
I thought
balls.
The only guy that's ever got Bobby out of the whole collection. Yeah. I'm like, is that Bobby? Yeah. I'm like,
oh yeah, he told me that.
Yeah.
What, did you look up the making of It's Always Sunny? They have Mac like vlogging like how they do it and stuff. It's really cool. It's like really old.
Which like?
The ones that we want for the backyard.
Oh yeah, Costco one.
It's definitely my favorite. Like.
All right, so we just wrapped on one of the biggest scenes in the script, which is the bar scene. Obviously, the script was written for a different setup for the bar. Nothing that wasn't impossible to handle and kind of adapt to on the fly. Very fortunate to have such amazing talent, especially local talent. Kind of at a loss for words after working through today, and it's not just because I'm tired, because I definitely am tired, but it's just everything started to snap together perfectly. The scenes really came together, the people really came together. You know, my wife pulled through in a clutch again, not with just set management, but helping the actors read through their lines. She actually stepped in and took on a tiny role in the film, which is a bartender. Obviously, since we lost the original bar, we lost the original bartender. Zach came through and ended up manning the mic boom. And he was there to do acting. You know, he showed up to, you know, he had a small role. And, you know, while he was there, he helped with everything possible. Everybody had input that was good. And so really, as a team effort, you know, this thing started to really kind of just tighten up and come together. And I'm very, very happy. So I'm about to check through some of this footage as I'm dumping it off of the SSD. Let's do that.
My understanding is that your best friend there is probably the reason you're back.
And you? What are you doing here on the night I get back?
You think they sent me here?
I know, since I've landed, I haven't exactly been alone.
Well, it should be expected since you did screw up your last gig.
Alright, so first view at the bar footage. It's really good. It is really good. It finally feels like a film that is looking like a film, feeling like a film. There are pieces of whole story now, so it's not just these random kind of clips and jump cuts like the intro was. Yeah, it is. I'm super stoked. I'm actually having a hard time pulling myself away from the edit. I'm pretty happy. I'll see you guys really soon. We will be filming again in about 2 days.
Okay. Right. I'm just gonna add him in there. I'm just gonna go from y'all's conversation and then like pan over to him installing it. And just sit there and like just film the entire process of how that happens.
Documentary.
And then like eventually like you guys will still be talking and I'll come back and it'll just
yeah. I'm sure he's only gonna be like probably 5 minutes.
I don't know.
Okay.
Well. That's it.
Yep. That's a wrap for today.
All right.
The happy armadillo.
Yeah.